you up early, cause I'm gonna take a ride with you. We're going down to the Honda shop, I'll tell you what we're gonna do. Put on a ragged sweatshirt, I'll take you anywhere you want me to. First gear, it's alright. Second gear, a lean ride. Third gear, hang on tight. Faster,
it's alright.
It's not a big motorcycle, just a groovy little motorbike. It's more fun than a barrel of monkeys, that two-wheel bike.
Hey guys, alright, so this is going to be a quick little video about how to check your air filter and how to replace it as well. So this is where your air filter is, this is where your air filter is right here. Okay, it's right above your kickstart, right here. This is your kickstart. Okay, so it's really simple. All you need is like a regular screwdriver, it doesn't have to be a special size, a smaller one. There are... think about 6 screws, like this, and I keep dropping crap. Yes, like this, okay? You just take them out. I put them right there so I don't lose them. Okay, you can see there's a screw hole there, a screw hole there, da-da-da-da, okay? This just pops right off. This is my brand new one. It's pretty and orange, as it should be when it's brand new, okay? Now, I'll show you what my old one looked like. Yeah, not pretty. And this was new, apparently this was new in May when I had it replaced professionally, but I don't think so. Anyway, that's pretty disgusting. If you see that, it's time for a new one. There are cleaners out there. I just decided to get a new one. The new one cost me $12, so really, get a new one. This is for the 2007 Yamaha Vino, and it's a paper filter that is coated in oil. So as far as I know, don't wash it with soap and water, that'll screw it up. If you see this and your scooter's acting kind of sluggish, it's probably because it's not getting much air. Okay, so if you do see that, all you have to do is just pull this right off. There you go. Okay, that's the inside of your air filter right there. Okay, this just pops on. It's incredibly simple. This is one of the first things that I ever tampered with. Was this. Okay, put it somewhere it's not gonna get dirty. Okay, this is the inside. Now, a couple times I have found fluid inside right here. This apparently is not to be that concerning. Sometimes moisture gets built up in here. It gets caught in this little bag right here. This can actually pop off and you can dump it out, and I just cleaned it out. Something you might want to test periodically, look for periodically. If you're really concerned about it, you can talk to a professional, but I talked to some and they said it's just moisture buildup, so it's not to be concerned. Okay, so like I said, this is $12. You just pop it back on. You put your cover back on. It actually stays in place on its own. And then you just put the screws back on. Alright, so that is how you change and check your air filter. Alright, so here I am again with my 2007 Yamaha Vino scooter. I'm going to be trying to extract my spark plug and checking it and then putting it back in. So this is your mat. This actually comes right off like this. Okay. And this is the compartment right here where your battery, your coolant, and your spark plug is. So it's really simple. You take a regular, plain old school screwdriver. You want to take this bolt off right here. I put it right there so I don't lose it. Okay. This pops off. Sometimes it likes to be stubborn. Oh, the washer too. Watch that. That needs to go in there. Okay. So this comes off. Here we go. So this is your battery. This is where your battery is. That's your coolant right there. And this little panel right here pops off. It's a little bit... sometimes it's hard. The first time I took it off was hard, but... and if you're confused about which way it goes back in, is the riding side where it says Yamaha on the inside. Okay, so we're gonna get up, we're gonna turn around, go to the other side. Okay, so like I said, coolant, pop that off. Probably should put some more in there soon, but it's not, you don't really go through coolant that much. This is your battery. This is the first thing I ever installed when I got the scooter. I knew nothing about it. The manual did a pretty good job of explaining this. This is pretty simple. If you're really uncomfortable with it, you can always ask someone who's mechanically inclined to help you. Okay, so your spark plug. This is your spark plug wire tube right here. Okay, your spark plug is going to be down there. So you have to grab this and have to yank on it a bit. It's kind of awkward. Wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. This one doesn't want to give back. There we go. Sometimes they're tough. Sometimes they're not so tough. Okay. So, this is what I just pulled out. Might want to get that a little bit of a clean. Okay, that's where the spark plug goes into, is right there, and that's where the spark is created. Okay, so we're gonna move that out of the way. And I can't really see terribly well, but okay, there, right there, right above that red wire, that's my spark plug right there. Okay, so I'm gonna get my tools and I'm gonna try and pull it out. Okay, so I've got my tools to do my spark plug extraction. Okay, so what this is a special socket, a spark plug socket. You can't really read it very well, but it's a 5/8 spark plug socket. These are specially designed to take out a spark plug. Okay, so that's where this is where the spark plug is going to go in. That's the part that attaches, okay? And then I've got, because it's way in there, you can't just get in there with regular size. I asked my neighbor to borrow his extension. This is what an extension is. It's just a really long arm. It gives you some leeway in there, okay? And your socket attaches to the bottom of this, okay? There you go. So that's attached now. And then you've got your ratchet, okay? And the ratchet obviously attaches like that. Okay, I'm gonna try and do it. There we go. So that's all one now. Ooh. Okay. Clunk. So, like I said before, our spark plug is in there. And what I'm gonna do, just for the ease, is I'm gonna disconnect these. Okay. This is part of your battery. This is your power feed. You have to kind of wiggle those off. I like to. It just gets them out of the way. Sorry if you didn't see that. I'm trying to. There we go. Make sure you put those back on. But that just kind of gets stuff out of the way for you. Okay. So we're going to try this. Here's my socket. I'm going to. There, it's on it. I'm going to try. Loosey goosey thing. So lefty loosey. I might have to put this arm down to do this. Sometimes it's hard. So hold on 2 seconds, guys. So I don't know if you can see that, but I did manage to get it out. It took a little bit of wrenching and I had to put the camera down because I needed two hands. But as long as you're forceful but steady with it, it'll come out. Okay, so I'm just going to put the camera down again. Okay, guys, so this is my spark plug. The camera focuses a bit more. I'm just going to turn it this way. All right. So, I'm not really sure if this is good or bad, if this is what it's supposed to look like. I'm just trying to find a good place where it's going to focus. There we go. All right. There's a, at the edge here, this is what causes the spark right here. This is, it's supposed to be sharp. It was kind of covered in gunk, so I, cleaned it up a bit. This little washer, I took that off and I cleaned that up a bit. I don't know, I'm gonna have to talk to people about whether or not this is a good spark plug, or if I need a new one. They're not too expensive. I think they go for about $20. Not sure. Anyway, but that's what it came out of. There's a couple. This is an NGK. It says right there, NGK. I'm sorry, it's not, my camera's not focusing. But yeah, that's basically it. That's your spark plug. Okay, so that's how you can take it out and check it. If it's gunky or if it's got a lot of white, apparently that's bad, but I'm not sure. Anyway, that's what it looks like. So you can always look at it and go, I have no idea, but here's it is. All right, so now I'm going to put it back in. Okay, so you've now seen how to take an air filter out of your Yamaha Vino, and also how to take a spark plug out of your Yamaha Vino, and also what your spark plug should not look like when it comes out of your Yamaha Vino. At the time, like I said, I had never seen a spark plug before. It's the first time for everything. I figured it was wrong, and as soon as I tried to put it back in and it wasn't popping back in, I knew something was wrong. Looked it up, sure enough, the metal threading on top of the spark plug head snapped off and was still inside. So after talking to some friends, I was able to get a screw extractor, which looks like a really fat drill with screws around the top, and it bites into any kind of thread, stripped or stuck screw, and you screw it out. It wasn't easy necessarily because I had to pop it into my extension and get it in there, and it was just difficult. I didn't film it because I was stressed out and I was just, nah. So, but I learned. Now I know to be gentle when I'm taking out the spark plug. I wasn't one that installed it. I had it professionally installed. So as far as I know, either whoever installed it incorrectly, or it was faulty and or rusted, or who knows. Learning. So this is my first video. I hope you guys like it. It is shaky and a little bit unorganized, but I'm hoping to do some more videos of scooter maintenance, that kind of thing. My boyfriend has a 1981 Vespa small frame that he has taken apart and put back to, or he's in the process of putting it back together right now. I'm learning lots from that. Different beasts, Vespas and Vinos are completely different, but still lots to learn. And we also have our big Garden City Rally coming up in May for the May Long Weekend. Huge rally. It's the 30th anniversary of this rally. It's been going on forever, and people come from all over the West Coast and down into Oregon and California to come up, and we go on long scooter rides. I'm going to be documenting my scooter's transformation into catbug. And if you don't know what catbug is, I will be putting links to catbug. It's a cartoon. I love catbug. I live for catbug, and my scooter is going to become catbug. Exciting. All right, so if you have any questions, please leave them down in the comments below. And if I'm completely wrong about something and you have suggestions about my maintenance, please let me know. I'm learning, and I love to hear advice, as long as you're not mean and calling me a silly woman, because then we'll have problems. All right, guys, see you later. Because I'm a Fujiyama mama, and I'm just about to blow my top. Fujiyama, Yama, Fujiyama.